Hello, and thank you for watching this video. My name is Deanna. Luckily, my cerebral palsy only affected that part of my brain that control movements, not its mental function. Probably, you wonder, why does she say, luckily, due to the severity of my physical condition, my intellectual ability represents a stroke of luck to be independent. Furthermore, it allows me to find ways to overcome my disability and adapt to my own life. Today, my video explains some steps to lessen overprotective actions and foster independence. First, let me define overprotective parents or caregivers. They usually want to shield their children from everything that might hurt or give them a hard time. The definitions of the keywords shield and everything on that sentence are the following. Number one, shield means to protect with or to provide with a protective cover or shelter, as well as to cut off from observation. Number two, everything means all that exists, all that relates to the subject, and all that is important. As you may see, overprotecting puts people with different abilities in an invisible cube. Thus, overprotection does not prepare your loved ones to face life. Let me give you a simple example. Suppose, years ago, my grandma didn't want me to use my equipment in the community. She argued that my disability makes me vulnerable. I could not talk, walk, or even use my hands to defend myself. In her mind, I could not go out by myself. She feared that something could happen to me. Nevertheless, she knew how she raised me, and she trusted my mental ability to prevent dangerous situations. Therefore, she let me go, giving me always her advice. Now, I am an educated and independent woman who has attained almost all her major goals in life. Now, the next question is how to lessen overprotective habits to let children solve little problems in life. Taking my adult experiences and remembering what my grandma and Aunt Elena did, allow me to recommend these points. Number one, allow and encourage children to practice their physical and intellectual abilities as much as possible. For example, if they can brush their hair or help you to write the grocery list, encourage them to do it. Teach them how to do things and let them develop their style. This way, when they are alone, they would know what to do. Seeing how your children handle themselves would give you peace of mind. I am confident that my grandma, God rest her soul, feels proud of the way I handle situations in life. Number two, expose children and teenagers to problems that they will have and deal with in their future. Then, teach them how to find solutions to those difficulties for them to get used to problem solving. Life is not easy. It's even harder for people with disabilities. Number three, give them little choices and explain the benefits and consequences if they make the wrong decisions. Then, let them deal with the consequences, which help them develop willpower. Yes, I know, you don't want your child to cry. However, it's better for your children to whine with you than to suffer because they don't know what to do and you are not there. Number four, as children mature, teach them how to be responsible. Unfortunately, it's easy to fall into stereotypes. Some people would assume that all people with disabilities could not be responsible for their actions or make decisions on their own. Thus, they must be led by others. You, as parents, must teach your children how to act responsibly. Teach them how to differentiate these kinds of situations and say no to stereotypes. Hopefully, you find these tips useful. Under the description, there is the link to the Spanish version of this video. Yes, I speak both languages. I would like to read your comments. Please, subscribe to my channel. Bye-bye. Stay tuned.